You're watching Dibber.
Hi, I'm Colin, and you're watching Dibber's British World.
Hi there, folks, and welcome to this week's episode of
What the Fuck Friday.
Yes, it is What the Fuck Friday again. Now, firstly, I'd like to thank Sally Handbag for today's intro. There's going to be a link to his channel down there. Please go and check him out. And if you like what you see on his channel, please subscribe to him. Now then, today's video is about a suspicious wife that causes a little bit of a problem in one of the high streets here in the UK. Now, basically, she's got this little idea in her head that maybe her husband is having an affair. Now then, her suspicions are based on the fact that his work hours have changed. Oh yes. Yes, her suspicions were based solely on the fact that he was working more hours than he used to. So what she did, she set about hiring herself a private detective agency who then fitted a unit to the underside of his car. Now, when this gentleman came back to his car one day, now I don't know whether he got down on his hands and knees and started searching around underneath his car, and if he did, I wonder why. But from what I can gather, he noticed there was something a little bit odd underneath his car. And on closer inspection, he found a device. Now, this guy had actually worked in the security industry himself before in the past. So what he did was, he got, you know, basically straight onto the police, who immediately sent out a fire engine. They sent out the actual police themselves. They sent out the bomb squad, and they sent out an ambulance. Now, this is when things get a little bit stupid, because basically they've turned up to defuse a tracking device that his wife has had fitted to his car. Oh yeah, her suspicions went so far that she actually got this company to put a tracking device on his vehicle to track where he was and at what times and how long he was there for. Only problem is, it really came back on her big style, because basically he made a phone call to her to explain what was going on, and she then had to admit that she had hired a private detective company to basically snoop on him. Now, in my mind, I mean, when a time comes in a relationship when trust is not there, and that's, you know, people start to doubt each other's words, as far as I'm concerned, there is no relationship. It's over. You know, because the moment trust disappears from a relationship, it then starts on a downward spiral. And I have seen this myself. Now, she thinks that she's having a hard time, and she gets suspicions over her husband, you know, keeping long hours at work. Now, this woman really should be, you know, try being married to somebody who's a member of a motorcycle club. Because I'm not joking. And girls that I've dated will tell you this. That when my phone has rung before in the past, when I used to be with the motorcycle club, I would answer the phone. She would ask who it was. I would say club business. And that was the last she could ask about it. Now then, I know that might seem cruel to some people, but sometimes, you know, depending what kind of lifestyle you lead, you do this to actually protect people, yeah? Because what they don't know, they can't tell. Anyway, what I'd like to know is what you guys and girls think of this. I mean, have you ever been in a relationship where somebody has accused you? Because that's essentially what she's done here. She's accused him of infidelity. Now, have you ever been in a relationship where somebody has actually, you know, gone to extremes to find out where you are and what you are doing? And, you know, maybe what would you do if you was in this guy's position? Because I know what exactly what I would do. There would only be two words that come out of my mouth, and the second one would be off. Anyway, guys and gals, I look forward to your comments on this one. I'm going to put a link to the story, as always, down there in the Brit Bar. Don't forget to go and check out the YouTubers' names that have appeared around me. They're all good. You all stay safe, and I will most definitely catch you all another day, another way. What was that? Mind your own fucking business what I'm doing. That's my business. It's nothing to do with you. This is my business. You, you, Mind your own business.